I'll be coming down. Are you right towards the front? You know, I don't actually know the number of my building, but I'll be coming down, and I'll be carrying her in like a green towel. So, if you're on the Fort Lowell side, I'll see you. Yeah. All right. I look forward to meeting your border collie. Okay. I'll see you momentarily. Hey, buddy. We're gonna go down, okay? Hey, come on, no fight right now. Hey, come on. Mowgli, wait. Don't need to fight right now. School, okay? We're gonna go meet a nice lady. Her name is Dorothy. She's gonna take you. Okay. And she got a nice doggy with her. I think she said his name's Frankie, okay? Come on. Let's go. I love you so much. Thank you. cremation lady. It was really sweet. She had a border collie in her car. His name was Frankenpoopy. And it was a really sweet dog. And he goes to work with her and does all the deliveries and the pickups. And he's there for people who are mourning. And poor Frankenpoopy. He has a really big tumor on his tummy. And he won't be around much longer. He's got cancer. He has trouble moving around. So she's in her own state of mourning. Grieving. It was really cool. She gave me these flowers. You like her name? She was really sweet. Her name's Dorothy. And she gave me these flowers. I was gonna say it is finished, but I guess it's just the beginning or the continuation. It was really interesting the different ways that the cats interacted with Polka when she was sitting here. Wayne gave her so many kisses and loved her and just kept laying down nearby and watching her. And he would walk over and he'd give her more kisses. And Gretel, she acted how she acted with her 2 days ago, the last night Polka was alive. It's like, it's kind of weird because Gretel, she was reaching at Polka, and she doesn't typically reach at Polka. She goes in her house and sleeps with her. Sometimes I catch her in there sleeping, but she was like reaching at her on her nose when I was feeding Polka the other night, and then today she just wanted to play with her. So I don't know, usually Gretel doesn't pay any attention with her, she doesn't pay any attention to her, but today when Gretel sniffed Polka, she like started playing with her like she's one of her toys, or wanting to wake her up and hear her squeak and play with her that way. I don't really know, but so that was an interesting interaction. And then Mowgli, he walked over and he sniffed her, and then he went back over and laid down. It was kind of funny because Mowgli's so lazy. I wanted him to have the opportunity to say goodbye, but if I didn't pick him up and bring him over next to me, he wouldn't have come over. He would have just slept. So right after he went and lay back down, I'm like, come on, Mowgli, are you sure? And then several minutes later, I picked him up again and put him on my lap and was petting him. And sniffed her again, but then he went and got a drink of water, so I went and laid back down again. So it's interesting seeing all the different ways that the cats say goodbye. But Gretel, you know you can't swipe at Polka like that. Anybody who swipes at Polka gets in trouble. What are you doing? It's interesting because every so often I hear stuff over in her house area. I hear something move, or interesting last night when I was petting her. Brandon was sitting on the bed and he heard like her chittering noise that she makes, like, coming from where she was. So interesting, because, and I mean, I like supernatural stuff and spirits and paranormal, but it definitely had an uncanny feeling. I definitely got nervous for a little while. It was interesting feeling nervous about coming home. But walking in here and seeing Pocahontas, it wasn't as nervous as, you know, it's interesting how your mind makes you think that it'll be one way and then it's something totally different. Well, I really appreciate everybody who's reached out and sent me nice messages, and it's weird to be on the, you know, usually I'm not the one who's has the most grieving stuff going on, but I think it's interesting to be the one on the receiving end. And when people say, oh, I'm so sorry for your loss, I guess it actually does mean something. Because I appreciate everyone being sad, for me being sad, and for Poca passing away. So, it's nice. It feels nice to have people say they're sorry, even though there's nothing that they need to be sorry about. They're just sorry that we have to experience it, but there's no need to be sorry. I like what Ethan said earlier. Let me see if I can find it. He sent me a message today.
Can't blame yourself for the circle of life. It's okay to grieve, but these things just happen. It's the natural way. So hang in there. I love you.
I can't blame myself for the circle of life. That was her journey. And clearly she wanted to do it alone. Well, we will put these pretty flowers in a vase. It's so nice of her to bring me flowers. And I'm gonna go take a bath, and I'm gonna make a cup of milk and eat some cookies and put a bath bomb in the bath and have a really nice, peaceful, cozy time. It's just a circle of life. And my circle's still moving.